We'll wait for another minute.
बस इतना ही रहता है भैया धावा देता है मतलब कितने स्टार जा रहे हैं ये स्टार
ओके वी विल वेट फॉर वन मिनट लेट अदर्स जॉइन गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ओनली 8 और ऑन है वी विल वेट फॉर अदर 1 मिनट Okay, so in the last class we were discussing about addition and subtraction of algebraic expression. So in this class we'll discuss about multiplication of algebraic expressions. Okay, so let us take some questions. 3x multiplied by 4x. So let us start with simple questions. 3x multiplied by 4x. So already you know how to multiply. So whenever you are multiplying, you have to multiply the numbers, and if variables are there, you have to multiply variables with variables. So you'll get 3 into 4, you'll get 12, x into x, you'll get x square. So let us take one more question. Let's try the numbers. 7xy multiplied by 3x square. 7xy multiplied by 3x square. So what we are doing, we are multiplying monomial with monomial here. Okay, after that we'll learn how to multiply monomial with binomial. So all of you write your answers. 7xy multiplied by 3x square. So multiply the numbers 7 into 3, you will get 21. X into x square, you will get x cube. And only y is there, you write that y as it is. So multiplication of monomials is very easy. So let us continue to the next topic, that is multiplication of monomial with binomials. 3x multiplied by 5x plus 3y. So here it is monomial and this one is a binomial. So we are multiplying monomial with binomial. So whenever you are multiplying monomial with binomial, you have to use distributive property. Okay. So when you are using distributive property, you have to multiply 3x with 5x. 3x you have to multiply with 5x plus again 3x we have to multiply with 3y. 3x you have to multiply with 5x also, and again 3x you have to multiply with 3y also. So 3x into 5x you get 15x square. 3 into 5 into 15, x into x you get x square plus 3x into 3y, 3 into 9, and x into y will get xy. Arya, please check your answer 24, x square, y you are writing for which question you are writing. Okay, you are writing for this question only. See, after multiplication, can we add here? No. Why? Because they are not like terms. If x square term is there, then only we can go for addition. Here we are having x square term, and here we are having xy term. And it is not multiplication, so it is addition. So since they are not like terms, we have to stop here only. Further, don't go for addition. What we are doing? You are adding 15 plus 9, you are writing 24, and x square plus xy will get x cube y. So that is wrong. Okay. So after this, we cannot simplify further because they are not like terms. So let's take one more question. I know most of them, they will make the same mistakes. They will do up till here. After that, again they will multiply. Again they will be adding that. Even though they are not like terms, they will simplify that also. Let's take next question. 4x multiplied by 3x square minus 12ab. 4x into 3x square minus 12ab. So what is the answer of this question? Okay. So 12x cube minus 48xab. Okay. So now again, what you have to do here, 4x you have to multiply with 3x square minus is there. 4x again you have to multiply with 12ab. So how much you will get? 4 into 3, first multiply the numbers, then you multiply the variables. 4 into 3 you will get 12, x into x square you will get x cube, minus 4 into 12 you will get 48, x into ab will get xab. So this is the final answer. Let us take one more question. Three x plus 5y multiplied by 2a plus 3b. So this is multiplication of binomial with binomial. Earlier we had done multiplication of monomial with binomial. So now what we are doing? We are multiplying binomial, two terms with two terms. So all of you do it and write your answers in the comment section. So multiplication of binomial with binomial, already in the last classes also I told how to do that one. you have to use distributive property two times. Okay, we got one answer from Arnav and also from Sanjeev. Sanjeev, okay, Sanjeev has not given answer, right? Okay, let us do one question after that. You can start solving that. So now what you can do, you can take this complete term or binomial as one term. So now using distributive property, this you have to multiply with 2a, and again this you have to multiply with 3b. First we are using distributive property, and again you have to go for distributive property once again. Okay, so 3x plus 5y we are multiplying with 2a first. Next, what is that plus? Write the plus. Again, 3x plus 5y we are multiplying with 3b. First we are multiplying with 2a, and again 3x plus 5y we are multiplying with 3b. And between whatever the sign is there, you write it here. Plus is there, we are written plus here. So now, again distributive property. We are having binomial and here we are having monomial. So this 2a we have to multiply with 3x also, and we have to multiply with 5y also. So you will get 3x into 2a, we are multiplying 2a with 3x, plus 5y into 2a. 2a we are multiplying with 5y also. Now, plus again 3b you have to multiply with 3x also. 3x into 3b plus 5y into 3b. 3b you have multiplied with both the terms. Now you multiply it, how much you will get? 3x into 2a, 3 into 2 will be 6, x into a you will get xa. Plus 5y into 2a, 5 into 2 you will get 10, and y into a you will get ya, or you can write it as ay also. Plus 3 into 3 will get 9, x into b will get xb. Plus 3 into 5, 15, y into b will get 1b. So now all of you check whether you are having like terms or not. Like terms means if you are having xa term, you have to simplify with xa only. So do we have any xa terms? No. So we don't have any like terms here. So this will be your final answer. Sanjeev is having some question. By. Okay, that is the correct answer. So I hope all of you understood how to multiply binomial with binomial. So let's take one more question on multiplication of binomial with binomial now. Three a plus 2b multiplied by 2a plus 7b. So all of you multiply this one now and write your answers in the comment section. Okay, we got answer from Arna, Chardania, and Shubham. So let's start solving it. So as I told, you can take this one as a one term, or you can take this one as one term. It is your wish. So I have taken this one as one term. So 3a I'm multiplying with this. Again, 2b also I have to multiply with this. So you will get 3a into 2a plus 7b. This, and this term I am taking it as one term. 3a I am multiplying with 2a plus 7b plus 2b, again I am multiplying with 2a plus 7b. So now use distributive property. So instead of writing this step, you can directly skip the step and you can write your answers. So you have to multiply 3a plus 2a. 3a into 2a will get how much? 6a square plus 3a into 7b, you will get 21ab. So directly I am multiplying. So I am not writing this step, directly I am skipping the step and directly I am writing my answer. Now, plus 2b into 2a, how much you will get? Plus 4ab, or ba you can write. Now, plus 2b into plus 7b, how much you will get? Plus 14b square. Now, we have to check whether we have like terms or not. If you have like terms, you have to simplify them. Okay, otherwise that will be your final answer. Now let us check whether they have like terms or not here. A square terms, we don't have. AB terms and BA terms. If you are writing BA, so AB terms and BA terms both are like terms. So these two we have to simplify here. Okay, 6A square plus 21 plus 4, how much you will get? 25AB plus 14B square. So this is the final answer. So if you have like terms, you have to simplify in the last term. Only you have to simplify the like terms. Don't add all the things. Let's take one more question. Four x minus 3y into 3y minus 2x. 4x minus 3y into 3y minus 2x. So all of you multiply it. And here we are having 2 negative signs. So while multiplying, you have to be very careful. So take care of signs and multiply them. So write your answers fast. Okay, Shubham has given the answers. Let us wait for others also. Okay, let us start doing this question. So you are having 4x, this you take it as one term. 4x you have to multiply with 3y minus 2x. And again, see the sign here, minus 3y is there. Minus 3y you have to multiply with 3y minus 2x. So I have taken this as one term. Now, 4x into 3y, you will get 12xy. Minus is there, you put the minus. 4x into 2x, you will get how much? 8x square. So this is very simple because only one minus is there. And here you have to be very careful. While multiplying the second term, you have to be very careful because outside you are having minus. Now, minus 3y into 3y. Minus 3y into plus 3y, how much you will get? Minus 9y square. Minus 3y into 3y, you will get minus 3y square, minus 9y square. And again, minus 3y into minus 2x. Minus into minus, it will become plus. If you have any confusion, you can write them separately and you can multiply them. Okay. So, minus into minus, it will become plus. 3 into 2, you will get 6. Y into x, you will get yx, or you can write it as xy. Xy and yx, both are like terms. So, now, check whether you have any like terms or not. XY, 12XY and 6XY, they are like terms. Okay, so 12 plus 6 will get 18XY minus 8X square minus 9Y square. So this will be your answer. Okay, so let's check how many of you did that answer. And then the last term is wrong, 6xy you are done. Arya also, your first term is wrong. Piyush also, and Shubham, okay, you got correct answer, Shubham. And now you have to simplify, okay. 12xy and 6xy, you are not simplified, you have to simplify that. Rest everything is fine. So others, please try it. Others were not writing their answers. Let's take simple question now. 3ab, or you can take 3a square b multiplied with 6xa minus 4yb. So it is multiplication of monomial with binomial. At least you can do this one, you can do. Okay, so let us do this one. Sandhya, what you are writing that is equal to? From where you are writing that is equal to sign? Okay, so 3a square b, we have to multiply with 6xa and minus 3 a square b, we have to multiply with 4 by b. 3 a square b, we have to multiply with both the terms. So now multiply 3 into 6, you get 18. A square into a, you get a cube, and b term only 1 is there, and x term only 1 is there. So you have to write them as it is. Minus 3 into 4, you will get 12. A square, we don't have any term to multiply it, and b into b, you will get b square, and only y is there. So this is the answer. 18 a cube bx, 18 a cube bx minus 12 a square b square y. 12 a square b square y. Let's take the next question. 5x5 into 6a minus 3x plus 7y. Okay. Okay, so let us start doing this question. 5xy multiplied by 6a minus 5xy multiplied by 3x plus 5xy multiplied with 7y. So this 5xy you have to multiply with all the three terms. Okay, so how much will you get? 5 into 6 you will get 30. xya minus 15 x square y, x into x into x square, only y time is there, plus 35, 5 into 7 will be 35, x, y into y will get y square. Further, we cannot simplify because we don't have any like terms there. Let's take the last question. After this, we will wind up our class. X to the power of 4 plus 1 by x to the power of 4 multiplied by x into 1 by x. So all of you do this question, after that we'll wind up our class. Anybody got answer? This one is an easy question. Like as we are doing multiplication of binomial with binomial, the same way you have to do for this question also. Harnav, check your answer. Okay, we are having only 2 minutes. Let's do this question. We'll take this as one term. We'll get x to the power of 4 into x plus 1 by x plus 1 by x to the power of 4 into x. Sorry, this is plus. Sorry, I had given wrong there. It was plus here. Okay. So, plus 1 by x. So multiply we will get x to the power of 4 into x. If you want, you can write them separately. X to the power of 4 into x plus x to the power of 4 into 1 by x. So x to the power of 4 we are multiplying with both the terms plus 1 by x to the power of 4 into x. 1 by x to the power of 4 we are multiplying with x plus 1 by x to the power of 4. Again, we are multiplying with 1 by x. So here it was plus, not multiplication. So now, x to the power of 4 into x, we will get x to the power of 5 plus, and here 1 x will be cancelled. X to the power of 4 divided by x, we get x to the power of 3 plus. Here, again, in the denominator, 1 x will be cancelled. So we will get 1 by x to the power of 3 plus 1 by x to the power of 4 into x, we get 1 by x to the power of 5. So this will be your final answer. We cannot simplify that. All the terms are different there. Okay. So thank you all.